morning. How are you, Bert?
Great. Good morning, Gordon.
Oh, hi, Big Bird.
How are you?
Nice day.
Nice day. Hi, kids.
Hi, Big Bird.
Hi, Mr. McIntosh.
Hi, Big Bird.
Nice morning, isn't it?
Sure is.
Hi, Olivia.
Hi, Big Bird. How are you?
Oh, great. What a beautiful day. Hi, old Barkley, old fella. Oh, boy. I love a nice sunny morning. Gee, I've said hello to everybody, including you. Hi. But I haven't said hello to the sun.
Good morning, Mr. Sun. Welcome to the sky. Shine on all the little creatures as you're passing by. Stop yawning, Mr. Sun. Time to make a day. Brightening every little corner as you go your way. The moon and stars are fine at night. But when it's day, we need your light. So we say, keep shining, Mr. Sun. Smiling in the blue. All the little children smiling back at you. And birds and bees, the flowers, the trees, the whole wide world will seem to say, good morning, Mr. Sun. Good morning, have a nice day.
Erase. E.
Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here to show you what's inside of Harry Monster. Now, Harry, if you'll just sort of take your place up there, we can get started.
I can't wait to find out what I'm like.
Okay, well, just turn on the machine here. And there.
Boy, I'm crowded.
Yeah, now as you can see, there's a lot of stuff inside of Harry Monster. I see right here, keeping things protected are Harry's ribs.
You see? Oh, that tickles.
Mm-hmm.
Only joking.
Yeah. Well, you see now, they kind of sort of rise and fall every time Harry breathes. Now, if Harry were to take a deep breath, Harry, why don't you take a deep breath?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Very good, Harry. Now, as you can see, every time Harry breathes in, he fills his lungs up here with air, and he breathes out, and his lungs empty. Now, there's even more stuff underneath all this stuff here. So let me just, I'll dial out Harry's and bring in. There we go. Now, here is Harry's heart beating away ker-chunk, ker-chunk.
Doesn't look like a heart.
Well, actually, it's sort of a big muscle working to pump blood all around Harry's body. And looking even deeper in Harry's body, there we've got the pipe that goes from Harry's mouth to his tummy.
Mm.
Now, Harry, why don't you say ah?
Ah.
Now, eat a cracker, Harry. Now, if Harry eats a cracker, you'll see little bits of cracker that will go down the pipe down into Harry's tummy where they all get kind of mushed up, you see? And, of course, there's other stuff. There's other stuff in there. There are things like a, let's see, there's a liver and, yeah, there's a liver there and there's some intestines here and all kinds of other bits and pieces and odds and ends and stuff like that. So now you know what's inside a hairy monster.
Well, what about my muscles?
Well, Harry, if we showed your muscles, we wouldn't be able to see the rest of your insides because they sort of cover everything else up, you know?
Well, my muscles are my best part.
Okay, well, let's see, running back through that, we come to Harry's muscles.
Oh, look at that definition.
Yep. So now you've seen what's inside of Harry, and what's inside of Harry is almost the same as what's inside of a kid like you or a frog like me.
Oh, I gotta see what this looks like close up.
Wait a minute. Harry, how'd you do that?
Whoa, look at those pecs.
But wait a second.
Wow.
Something's wrong
here. Poetry in motion.
Let's check the back here. Hey, what? Oh, Harry, why are you doing this?
Did you say he's playing hockey?
Sí, él juega hockey.
We're looking for a rectangle. Now you gotta find a rectangle for me. I know you can see that rectangle. Come on. Yeah. Go ahead. Now I'm watching you. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. That's it. You got it. It's a rectangle. Now, erase that. Yeah. Now, let me see a circle. Find me a circle. Go ahead. Uh-huh. A circle. Well, you started out right. Yeah. Go. Mm-hmm. A circle. That's a good circle. All right, now, erase that one. Erase that one. All right, now, where's the other circle? Yeah, two circles and a rectangle.
What a nice store.
May I help you, madame?
Yes, please. I'm looking for something in a coat.
Very good, madame. What sort of coat?
Well, let me think. I want something furry and blue.
I think I have the very coat, madame. I will show it to you.
Oh, good. What a nice store this is. I must tell Myrtle about this.
Is it not exquisite, madame?
Oh, it certainly is. What a beautiful furry coat. But I wanted something blue.
Blue?
Yes.
Yes. Madame has very particular taste. But I have another coat to show you.
What a pleasant man. Such nice service here.
Yes. Perhaps this is more to madame's taste.
Oh, that's a beautiful blue coat. Nice buttons, too. But I wanted something furry.
Well, I regret it, madame, but I have looked and I can't find a coat which is both blue and furry.
Oh, dear.
What?
Look at that!
What? Where?
Isn't that a beautiful coat? Why, it's just what I wanted. It's furry and blue.
Thank you.
Let me try it on.
What?
And it fits perfectly. I'll charge it and wear it home.
Lady? Lady?
But, madame...
Big. Large. Huge.
Immense.
Humongous. Gargantuan.
Okay, block it, block it. Go, go. Go for a goal, go for a goal. Hi. You know me? I spend a lot of time on one street. But once in a while, I want to go somewhere else. And I have to cross the street to do it. But like you, I'm not old enough to cross the street by myself. So that's why I use a grown-up friend's hand. Yes, with this hand, I'm able to cross the street, whether I'm on Sesame Street or anywhere in the world. A grown-up friend's hand. Don't cross the street without it.
Once upon a time, there was a four that was more than just a four. It was Funny Four. One, two, three, four people. One, two, three, four fish. Monkeys. Funny Four.
Hello, scale. What do you say? Tell me, how much does it weigh? Is it heavy? Is it light? Can you weigh it up just right? Ounces, pounds, what does it weigh? Tell me, scale, what do you say? Apples, oranges, seedless grapes, onions, string beans, kale, lobster, flounder, octopus, they all go on a scale. Trucks and meats and diamonds, they get weighed up too. Pastrami, pickles, packages, why there are even scales for you. Hello, scale, what do you say? Tell me, how much does it weigh? Is it heavy? Is it light? Can you weigh it up just right? Ounces, pounds, what does it weigh? Tell me, scale, what do you say?
Let's see. For oatmeal surprise, just take 12 cups of oatmeal, Melba toast, and an avocado. Get a decorative plate, and you will, Ernie.
Yes, Bert.
Hey, Ernie, will you tell me?
Bert.
For any festive occasion, you will enjoy this wonder... Ernie? Okay, now, see, Ernie...
Oh, yes, Bert. Just a minute, Bert.
Ernie, okay, stop. Stop, Ernie, stop.
Yes, Bert.
Ernie, would you do me a favor?
What's that, Bert?
Just do me one favor, from buddy to buddy, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me something. What are you doing?
Oh, well, you see, Bert, I was just taking this water.
I know, you were taking this water from the kitchen, and then when you go out the front door, you come back, and the glass is empty, and you go in the kitchen for more water. Well, what's going on?
Well, you see, Bert, I'm just carrying
water. Oh, I know what's going on, Ernie. I guess you're watering the flowers outside. That's very nice, because flowers need water. It's very good.
No, Bert. Flowers do need water, but that's not what I'm doing, Bert.
Oh? I wonder what... Oh, I know. Ernie?
Just a minute, Bert.
Ernie? I know what you're doing. Stop! I know what you're doing. You have a dog or a cat outside there, and it's very thirsty, and you're bringing a glass of water, right? Because animals need water, too, just like flowers, right?
Well, animals do need water, Bert.
Yeah, I thought so.
Yes,
it's very kind of you.
Well, that's not what I'm doing, though, Bert. Excuse me.
Oh. Well, what are you doing?
Just a minute, Bert.
What's he doing? Oh, I know what he's doing. Ernie, stop. Stop. Hold it. I know. Susan and Gordon are outside, right?
They are?
Yeah, that must be it. Yeah, and it's hot outside, and they need a glass of water, and that's what you're doing. You're bringing them a glass of water. Because people need water just like flowers and animals.
Well, Bert,
nice,
well, Bert, people do need water just like flowers and animals, but that's not what I'm doing, Bert. Excuse me.
Not what he's doing. Hey, Ernie?
Bert.
I tell you what, all this talking about water has made me kind of thirsty. Do you mind if I have a glass of water there?
Oh, sure, Bert, here.
Oh, thanks. Thanks, Ernie.
Oh, sure, Bert. There's lots more where that came from.
What do you mean?
Oh, well, Bert, you know the kitchen faucet?
The kitchen faucet, yeah.
Yeah, well, it's broken, Bert.
It is?
Yes, you see, the water's running all over the kitchen floor, and I wanted to carry the water outside before the whole house flooded, Bert.
Oh, no.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, Ernie, why didn't you tell me sooner, Ernie? Look at that. Uh-oh.
¿Qué es esto? What is it? Un pájaro.
A bird.
Sí, es un pájaro.
And here they are, the alphabet dancers. I wonder what they're going to do for us today. They're twirling around and they're on the ground, and now they have just formed the capital letter I.
Howdy, stranger.
Hello.
Wow, am I glad to see you.
Yes.
I'm plumb lost. Can you tell me the way to the city?
What's a city?
A city. You know, a city.
No, I don't know.
Oh, well, here, look, I'll show you. See, a city has lots of, put up there, buildings and stores and houses.
I see.
Uh-huh, and cars. Buses, trains, and trucks to bring all kinds of things in and out.
Uh-huh.
And cities have always got lots of people.
People?
Yes. Now, can you tell me the way to the city?
No, I'm afraid not. You see, I'm lost, too. By the way, what are people?
Sesame Street fever. Gee, where did everybody go? That's very bizarre. I guess this is it, huh? Yeah, I just do the stands here. Is this the way you... is that how you do it, like that?
More.
Hey, hold on there, Sonny.
There is no more. Yeah, we're closing now. Watch your feet.
Well, I guess it's out, out, out the door. Out, out, out the door.
Okay, who likes cowboys?
Me.
Yeah, okay. And who likes baseball?
Me.
Oh, well, that's good. You know why?
Why?
Because right now, I'm going to read you a story about a famous cowboy baseball game. And it's called Home Run on the Range. The story of a strange and unforgettable game. They say the folks that saw it will never be the same. The game was all tied. It was 5-5. And now the stands were coming alive. The Cowboys were up. They had 2 men out. And that's when the crowd started to shout. But suddenly, all the cheers turned to groans. For stepping to the plate was Forgetful Jones. Now, they all worried and had reason for that, because Forgetful forgot something that ended with at.
Oh, yeah, something important that ends with at. By golly, I didn't forget it. Yeah, it has to be my hat. Yeah. Okay, I'm ready. Pitch the ball.
His hat, oh! Now we're finished. Now we're done.
And as quick as a wink, it was strike one.
Strike one!
Yeah, don't worry, boys. I know hat didn't work, but I got something else that rhymes with that. I've had it since I used to sleep on it in kindergarten. Yep, it's my mat. Oh, my mat from kindergarten. Okay.
Oh, now he's gonna try hitting the ball with his mat.
No. Now we're done for. Now we're through.
And before you knew it, it was strike two.
Strike two.
Go get the bat!
Huh?
Bat? Oh, yeah, bat! Thanks for reminding me, boys. A bat is just what I need. Oh, there's my bat. Oh, okie dokie.
And now, with the bat in Forgetful's hands, a wave of excitement swept through the stands.
He's holding the bat!
And it's nice and fat.
Forgetful gave a great big smile and hit that ball a country mile. And now the stands were filled with cheering and fun. But guess what? Forgetful Jones forgot to run.
I think I'm supposed to do something now, but I can't remember.
Maybe I should do a little dance. Maybe I should sing. Maybe I should do both.
Home run, home run on the range, where the deer and the antelope play baseball.
And so that's the story of how Forgetful Jones hit a home run on the range, but lost the game anyway.
Aww.
And that's the end.
Cookie.
for me, huh? Yeah, thank you. Oh, you eating cookie? Cookie not for me. Oh, cookie for me. You put it on table for me. Oh, thank you. Oh, cookie not for me. Cookie for you. Oh, cookie for me. Oh, boy, cookie. Get cookie on. Oh, boy. You like cookie, too. Like chocolate cookie. You know what? You getting dressed all dirty. Give cookie to me. Me no care if me fur get dirty. Oh, you still eating cookie, huh? Look delicious. Hey, got terrific idea. You eat cookie. When you finished, me give you a big kiss and the cookie off face, okay? Hey, I tell you what, you come home with me and we eat cookies all day. Got closet full of cookies. Yeah! Oh.
La 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 la.
They're coming, the door's open.
Hello. Yep. I bet you know who I am.
I can't say as I do, lady.
Oh, well, I'll give you a hint. You're all dwarves, right?
Yeah, so what? Mm.
Well, I'm Snow White.
Hmm? That's terrific, baby. Pleased to meet you. What can we do for you?
Oh, well, now I'm not sure I'm in the right place here. How many dwarves are there here?
How many? That's a good question.
Yes.
Let's see. There's Pokey.
Yeah,
and
that's
then
Pokey.
There's Sparky. Mm-hmm. And
Flaky.
Let's see. Flaky, yeah. Mm-hmm. And then there's Sneaky mm-hmm. and Pokey.
No, you know, you named Pokey. You already named me already.
Oh, I did.
Yeah.
Yeah, we gotta do something else. Let's count off. Let's get in a big circle.
Oh, okay, all right. Yeah. Get in a circle and we'll count
okay,
off.
Okay,
huh?
Now, only right. When we count off, jump up so we'll know.
Okay.
I'll start.
All right.
One, two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten,
11,
oh, wait a
12,
moment. 13, dwarves.
14,
oh, dwarves.
15,
16. Oh, just a moment. Oh, hush now.
Oh, wait a second.
Just a moment. I have been watching
you. I got counted twice.
I got
yes,
counted a couple of times,
now,
too.
That's okay. It's good for you.
Let's all settle down.
I got counted three
if you
times.
All talk, you can't hear me. So let's all settle down. This is no good. When you count something, you are supposed to count everything one time only. Now, let's all line up and I'll count you. Let's go. Line up.
Okay, line up, everybody.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that's right.
Line up. There we go.
Line
here
up. You over there and you there. All right, now. Here we go. And who is this?
I'm Sparky.
Yes, Sparky, you will be number one.
Number one.
Yes, who's this right here?
I'm Snooky.
All right, Snooky, you'll be number two.
Number two.
Who's your little friend here?
Little friend? I'm Pokey, lady.
All right, Pokey, you'll be number three.
Okay.
And who's with you, Pokey?
I'm Flaky.
Flaky, I'm sorry to hear that. You'll be number four.
All right,
and who is this little sweetheart here?
I'm Drippy.
Drippy, you'll be number five.
Mm.
And little dear, what's your name?
I'm Sneaky.
Sneaky, you'll be number six. And, well, where's the other one?
There's not any other one. We're only six of us.
But, isn't this the cottage of the seven dwarfs?
No. This is the cottage of the six dwarfs. You want the cottage of the seven dwarfs, that's on down the street. You go down about three doors and turn left at the post office.
Oh. I'm terribly sorry. La 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 la.
No, she was weird.
Yeah, you suppose we ought to call the seven dwarfs and warn them?
Good idea.
Yeah, could be.
Stop! No one crosses this bridge by me. Unless they can answer my questions three.
All right, bridge keeper. What are the questions?
What is this?
A square.
How many sides does a square have?
One, two, three, four. Four sides.
What is a square good for?